They said I look like a left eye. And it was actually a teacher of mine, my commercial acting teacher, that said I looked like her, but and then said I should consider doing a project about her. And then randomly people would keep saying, you should consider doing a project about left eye. Mm-hmm. So there was a point that I was like, okay, let me actually look into this. And I was at Southwest by Southwest Film Festival the year that Last Days of Left Eye premiered. And I was sitting in the audience watching it, and I said, how would you feel if this was a narrative about left eye and you didn't have a part? And that's when I knew I needed to move on it. And that's how it started. I started researching it for years and wrote it for about 2-3 years, then called this guy, right? Nope, Facebook.
Yeah.
And I was like, he responded. And then we spoke, and one of the things he said to me was,
wanted to learn more about Lisa, you need to go to Honduras, you need to visit Lucia and, you know, experience the things that she experienced.
Awesome.
And she did it.
Yes.
So for Lisa, you know, going to Honduras and visiting Lucia where Dr. Sabi was, that was a major part of her change, you know, her change in spirituality, her change in how she was eating, her views on life, and you know, just her wanting to spread that message to all of her family and friends. And I think, you know, you can sit back and you can watch and you can listen, but it's never the same if you take part in it. And that's what I felt like. I was like, if you want to tell a true story of Lisa, you know, you can't just listen to what everybody else is saying. You have to go down there and experience it yourself so you know what it feels inside. You know what that change feels like inside. And you know, I think that's why it was so important. That's the significance of going to Honduras.